saying your whole, but you've been down the block this long, like maybe this, no, like this long, like no, guys, I'm not kidding you.
When I'm in a...
Hey guys, so today's video is going to be about Tinder in Japan. I've actually already made a video about dating in Japan, but I thought I would focus specifically on Tinder since it is the app I mainly use for my dating experiences. The reason why I chose Tinder is because I feel like it's one app with which you can actually kind of make friends more than a lot of the other apps on the market. And in Tokyo, I found that the use of this app is a little bit different than it can be, at least in Europe. Basically, I found that the first thing is that when you match someone on Tinder in Japan, they generally will write you a message that is gonna be like this long, like maybe this, no, like this long, like no, guys, I'm not kidding you. They basically answer you a whole lot of message, a whole lot of lines, and they basically give you like a full description of who they are and what they're looking for. Like basically the general message is Hajimemashite, machi ga arigato gozaimasu. お名前はさゆりです。趣味は音楽こと。They basically tell everything. And they say, please, let's be friends. よろしくお願いします。And it was kind of like amusing and shocking at the same time, but I think it's extremely lovely. And I just love these traits about Japanese people is that they're extremely polite and nice and also sweet in a way.And this is just like extreme courtesy. And at first I was a little bit like, I don't know, because I cannot first read kanjis and I can read Japanese hiragana and katakana, but I don't understand every word. My vocabulary is relatively small. So when they send me like this big paragraph, I'm like...
No!
But then I really enjoy because it gives you kind of like a clear, it's a bit robotic in a way, but it kind of gives you like a clear idea of what that person is about and everything. And it really makes you feel like they really want to get to know you and create like a genuine relationship with you, whether it's friendship or anything else. So I really appreciate that. The second thing about Tinder is that people use it here a lot to make friends. And a lot to make like foreigner friends. But I'll actually talk about the foreigner friends thing in another video. But yeah, I mean in Europe also you can, I think, make more friends on Tinder than compared to other apps. But here's like specifically some people actually download the app and use it even if they're like in a relationship or something. And I matched like some girls that had like a boyfriend or something, and they even had picture with the boyfriend. But when I generally, the way I use Tinder, I only like look at the first picture, and if I like it and I swipe right, and then if we match I check out the other pictures. And then either cancel or keep going. But as I'm in Japan, I'm very open to friendship, so I don't really care too much what the people look like. But sometimes I might just swipe like very randomly, as long as the people have like a sweet demeanor to them and I feel like we could coexist in a way. And yeah, so some girls had like some boyfriends and they were, oh, I have a boyfriend, I'm just looking for like friends or foreigner friends. And some guys are straight.
Well, well.
That's the second thing that, yeah, since people, basically I think people use it just like MySpace. Like, do you guys remember MySpace? I feel so old, or even older, high five. I feel that's the way people use Tinder here. So I found I matches also like a lot of guys, and among them, a lot of them were like actually straight. But they didn't care that I was bisexual or anything. They were just like, oh, are you gay or something? I was like, I'm bisexual. And they're like, oh, okay, I'm straight, but we can be like great friends, please. And then just keep talking. People didn't really seem to give a fuck. They just really value friendship. Japan is like a country where people kind of put the group before the individual. Friendship is like extremely valued, so I feel like that's why people are so eager to like connect and to like make friends. One thing though that I've noticed and that had happened to me a few times, now it's my personal experience, it's not really like a good look to talk about this and to say this, but I'm gonna say it anyway because I want to keep it real with you guys. But I've had a lot of people that I've matches actually not reply to me or like engage to me, like, hey, how are you doing, where are you from, blah blah blah, and then after a few questions, like, nothing. Where have you been? Cause I never seen you. Where have you been? And it's a little bit frustrating. I got so many matches here, so maybe that's why I felt like it happened more, because since I had way more matches. I don't want to brag or anything, but I felt like it makes sense anyway because people are very like busy here and they work a lot. So some people might maybe engage in conversation when they're like in the subway or something, and then after they go to work and they work like 8-9 hour shifts, and when they go home they just don't have like the strength again to like connect on Tinder. I mean, I've been in that place. Here I have a lot of free times, but I've been in that place, so I can kind of understand that behavior, but it's been a little bit like sad and frustrating to me. I also had some kind of weird proposition, like people trying to talk me into going to girls bar or boys bar. I'm not saying she's a gold digger, but she ain't messing with no broke. I'm saying she's a gold digger, but she ain't messing with no broke. They give me the honey when I'm in need. I'm in need. Want to be the bomb, met her at a beauty salon with the baby Louis Vuitton under her underarm. She said, I can tell you rock, I can tell by your charm. Far as girls, you got a flock. I can tell by your charm and your arm, but I'm looking for the one. Have you seen her? I'm not saying you're a hoe, but you've been down the block. And I was like, if one of us is gonna pay the other to go on a date, it's gonna be your child. So in a nutshell, I feel like Tinder is kind of like a good way if you want to like connect with Japanese people. Now you probably should speak Japanese, that would definitely help, because otherwise a lot of the people won't speak English, and that's what happened to me on my first trip. I had as well a lot of matches. I don't want to brag or anything, but I'm just saying. But then I couldn't engage and speak to them because they could only speak Japanese. But now I can actually engage in conversation, and even when it didn't follow through to much more, it was still kind of pleasant for me to like have conversation with Japanese people and engage with them, because in my opinion, that's how you really like get familiar and get to know culture, it's by engaging with the people. So thank you guys for watching, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to thumbs up if you did, and to subscribe and share if you want to see more. Keep yourself happy. Jana.